It is 6 o'clock. I'd like to call the regular meeting of the Clearlake City Council and Redevelopment Assessor Agency in the Clearlake City Hall Council Chambers at 14050 Olympic Drive in Clearlake, California, 95422. To order. Today is Thursday, April 28th, 2016. And can we have a roll call, Madam Clerk?
Councilmember Sabatier?
Here.
Councilmember Overton?
Here.
Vice Mayor Fortino Dixon?
Present.
And Mayor Perrone?
Present. Councilmember Sabatier, would you lead us in pledge?
Yeah.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Would you please remain standing? Could Tony Morales please come forward and offer our invocation? Thank you, Tony.
I'm out of touch.
Keep it secret.
Father, I'd like to thank you for allowing me to come here and pray for these council members, Lord God. You know they have a lot of things they have to make decisions about, things probably, some that weigh heavy on their heart, God, some things that can be done and can't be done, Lord. But I know that you rule kings and kingdoms, and that includes Clearlake, God. So I just pray that you just have your way today at this council meeting, Lord. And you would bless each member, God, as only you can. Help them to know that you love them, God, and you have a good plan for them and for this city, God. Just please bless this meeting, Lord, as only you can. And I just ask this in the name of Jesus, your son. Amen.
Amen.
Thank
you, Tony. All right, moving on. Mr. Folsom, any changes to the agenda?
Yes, Mayor. I'd like to pull item number 6. We're going to be coming back with a new first reading in the future, so.
All right, so we're moving item number 6 from the agenda. Very well, thank you. Any action, what's about the agenda? I'm moving a little faster.
I move to approve the agenda with
Any changes from council? Okay, go ahead.
And I will now offer a motion to adopt the agenda with the changes mentioned in moving number 6.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? There's none. We have a presentation from our Director of Public Works, Mr. Doug Heron.
Mr. Mayor, if I can first report that...
Oh, I apologize. I did that again.
I just want to report to the council that no reportable action took place in closed session.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Now, Mr. Heron, if you would.
Greg asked me to give you an update on last Saturday's event. That was our 10th annual citywide cleanup. As you can see, we had a good turnout. We had roughly 180 volunteers this year. The next one, what's up? Tim. A lot of good people. We set a new mark this year. We collected 220 yards of garbage coming in 31 tons.
Wow. 31 tons.
160 tires were picked up and 5 yards of e-waste. Great event. You know, we focused out by Pomo School. Go ahead, Tim. These are some of the pictures of the debris that we picked up. Wow. There's lots of it. I don't think we got it all, but we put a pretty big dent in it. Go ahead, Tim. These are just some slides. That's one of your operators, Clay Van Housen, on the backhoe. It's a lot easier to pick up more debris when we got the backhoe out there. We load up. We built up 8 30-yard dumpsters. Pretty good. We had Jeff Smith and Mr. Folsom was they were on the airboat and they went down towards the dam, collected up a bunch of garbage down there. We had the Interpretive Club, Anderson Marsh Interpretive Association, had the kayakers. They collected a lot of debris. A couple of boats come in. I couldn't believe what they were bringing in. A lot of stuff. And we only put a dent in it. There's a lot of stuff out there. So I want to give a special thanks to IGA Foods, Dennis Darling. He donated all the food. Everybody worked hard all day and got to come back down the park for a nice warm lunch. Very appreciative of them. CC4C, their efforts, huge. They come out with a big team. I'm sure Bruno will talk more on this. Crossroads came out, had a good team going on. That was about it. It was a good showing and monumental.
All the LDS.
So, my hat's off to all the volunteers. Thank you very much.
Very good. Thank you, Doug.
Dangerous neighborhood, and I don't know, feel like they kind of go up with a defiance to the city and the community, like, you know, we're going to do what we're going to do and mind your own business, and so I don't know, just want to kind of bring that my own personal opinion. I don't know if you guys do your, you know, prioritize what code enforcement needs, and once in a while you readjust what it needs or something like that, but with the garbage people, I know I talk to people who litter and stuff, you know, once in a while I talk to people, right? They're just kind of lazy, you know, or let things get out of control, they're humble, they're like, oh yeah, I need to fix this up. But, yeah, I feel like the fences are kind of like more of a defiance thing, you know, that kind of brings the community down in that way. So thanks for my minute and a half.
Oh, you're very welcome. Thank you for bringing that to our attention. And we also have Bill Shield.
If I may, before Bill Shield, Greg Ribby. Please always go into City Hall and submit a complaint form. I do believe our code enforcement do go after those fences, and so if you let them know and give an address, we will get right on that. And thank you also for being at the cleanup on last Saturday.
Mr. Shields, wanting to talk on road tax.
Good evening.
Good evening.
For years, practically everyone that has run for a seat has talked about road and streets in the city of Clearlake. This has been going on for 30 years. Once they get elected, well, the city don't have any money. Well, evidently, they do have money because they can come up with money to spend and waste for consultants. And these people, they say, well, 20% of the people or anti-tax. How do they know? I mean, where did they come up with that? I don't know anybody that's anti-tax in the city of Clearlake. Credibility, honesty, that's what it's all about.
Thank you, sir. We have no other public comment. comment cards submitted, but if someone would like to speak or address the council, this is the time to do it. Seeing none, I'll close public comment and move to the consent agenda. Any changes?
No, not for me.
Okay. Council members? Very well. Any public member wanting to change something on the consent agenda? Or open it up for discussion? Seeing none, I'll bring it back. Council members?
Mr. Mayor, I'd like to make a motion to approve the consent agenda as is.
I have a motion and a second. All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Seeing none, we will move on to our public hearing. Item five. I'm prepared to open the public meeting for approval of the revised housing and rehabilitation guidelines as required by Department of Housing and Community Development. Mr. Olson.
Thank you, Mayor. I'd like to introduce our grants coordinator, Adeline Brown.
Under the guidelines established by the Department of Housing and Urban Development, the Community Development Block Grant Program is now requiring that our housing rehab guidelines be separated into two guidelines, owner-occupied and tenant-occupied. They request that at a minimum they be separated by two sections, and we last reviewed them in January of 2014, but need to revise them in order to stay with their current rules. These will need to be adopted by resolution.
Thank you. Absolutely.
So basically what we're doing is just separating this. That's really not changing anything in the...
That's it.
We're just separating it.
And those are on page 16.
Very good. I got one. Any other comment, council? I'd like to open this up for public comment. If you have something you'd like to say on agenda item five, please step forward. Seeing no one rushing to the podium, I will bring it back. And close public hearing by motion, if I can get that.
Mr. Mayor, I'd like to make a motion to close public hearing.
I have a motion.
I'll second.
Motion and a second. Do we roll call vote?
Close.
No. All those in favor closing?
Aye.
Opposed? All are in favor. Yes, Mr. Sabatier.
I really liked the last portion of this, which was really good review for me, for the loan programs that we have for rehabilitation. And I'm not sure if it's now, but since it's in front of us, I really would like to have a presentation done for the public about all the types of loan programs that we have for rehabilitation. We have housing that really needs some help, and I think it would be appropriate for us as well as the public to hear a presentation from that, from our staff if possible.
Do you have a recommendation on how that's to be presented?
We're working on that with our current consultant, Adams Ashby, to get the program marketed out as due to code enforcement related problems to push the housing rehab program. They're planning on putting something together.
Would you like to do that at the city council to give a presentation?
I would love to, yes. So we can put it on TV and so we can be aware of it.
We might need to get consent for that, but what I was wondering is there information, because this should be readily available most of the time, we could have it on our website. And
yes,
is that something you're...
It is. It's on the website. It's right at the counter.
So, but it just needs to be
updated? No, we just want to push it more. It's
good.
It's updated.
We just need to talk about it to everybody.
Yeah, exactly. And I think the more we know about it, then the more we can put the word out appropriately.
I think, good point that it could be used as a resource with someone who's trying to come into compliance on some code violations. Mm-hmm. Great call.
So am I hearing consensus that you all would like to have a presentation on
I think it's a good idea, because I don't think enough people know the things, the loans and that we have at the city. I have to tell people all the time.
Okay. So yes, you have consensus. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we'll come back to that.
It's some pretty terrific interest rates.
Yeah.
All Anything else?
No, that was it.
So we need to...
I can find this.
I know, and we're all having difficulty finding the electronic resolution.
Mr. Mayor, I'd like to make a motion to approve the revised housing rehabilitation guidelines as required by the Department of Housing and Community Development, and adopt the resolution, which I don't have a number for.
Number 2016-16.
Number 2016-16, and read by title only.
Are you going to have a motion?
I'll second.
A motion and a second by Councilmember Overton. Roll call vote, please.
Councilmember Sabatier?
Aye.
Councilmember Overton?
Aye.
Vice Mayor Fortino Dixon?
Aye.
And Mayor Kurtolo?
Aye. Number six. Moving on to item seven. A report on the marketing ad hoc findings and recommendations, Mr. Folsom.
Thank you, Mayor. We've actually been having a really good success with our marketing ad hoc committee. I think we've been doing a number of kind of fun and interesting things. We had the San Francisco Chronicle ad that we were able to get out. One of the nice things about that is that we were able to do that in conjunction with a lot of local businesses, so we have a full-page advertisement in the San Francisco Chronicle. So that was pretty good. We have also brought to you at the last meeting our city logo contest, and we've gotten a number of submissions for that, so that seems to be going pretty well. And the latest thing that we're bringing to you today has to do with a city motto or slogan. Lots of cities have this. In your package, I gave you a number of examples that I won't go through right now, but some of them are pretty fun. I'll let you guys talk about your favorites. But many cities have a motto or a slogan that's aimed at enhancing a city's economic, cultural, historical, or aesthetic value. Mottos are a way of...
And that concludes our report.
Should I speak softer?
No, I think that was a sign.
All right, no motto, I guess. Mottos are a way of expressing a city's style or personality, highlighting its main appeal and strengthening its identity. They're part of a branding strategy to raise awareness of a city and help improve a city's image. A good motto should express a city's character, affinity, style, and personality, tell a story in a clever, fun, and or memorable way. They're unique and original, and inspire you to visit there, live there, or learn more about that city. So we came up with a couple of suggestions for you. First of all, Clearlake, South Shore Hospitality. And part of that was because just even my own experience when I first came to the to Lake County was that everybody seemed to be really nice. And that's, I think, kind of everybody's impression of Lake County and Clearlake, is that people are just really nice here. So South Shore Hospitality.
Southern hospitality, a little play on that.
Clearlake, living the lake life.
Kind of like living the dream.
Exactly, exactly. One of the mayor's favorite phrases.
Kind of like, I got living the thug life running through my mind.
We all live up in our own ways. Clearlake, sun, fun, and fishing. Clearlake, where community comes first. Clearlake, home of the international worm races. I'm sure we all are aware of that.
That's a lot of letters to put on a police car.
And then...
Well, we don't have to land on the police car.
And then not to bias anybody.
Yes, come on!
But Clearlake, get your bass over here.
We love it. That was great. So great. It was awesome. We had a good time.
Once I got it, I think it's hilarious. But I did read it a whole bunch of times. Get your bass over here. That doesn't make any sense.
You don't fish.
Exactly. So anyone who doesn't fish might not get it.
So our recommended action is to discuss and approve a city motto. It doesn't necessarily have to be one of these, but these were some that we recommended. And again, we did offer you kind of a bunch of examples in the back. And that concludes my presentation.
Thank you, sir.
Why don't you leave that up there, Tim, just in case?
Sir?
Yes, please.
Light?
Let me just get this side.
Thank you, guys. All right, any comments? Seeing none, I'll open this up. Any member of the community like to make a comment about, let's get your pass over here.
I could make comments about each and every one of those, and I'm sure none of you would appreciate any of my comments. Who was on this ad hoc committee that came up with this stuff?
For marketing? Well, it was...
Ron Allen, me, and...
Councilmember Sabatier, Councilmember Overton.
I was there originally as well.
Members of the public.
What members of the public came from those days? Those are some slogan that you would use from the past. You need to...
Do you have one?
Not for the, well, yeah.
Okay, but that's G-rated.
No.
Okay, well.
But I think you need something a little bit more modern and a little bit more upbringing here. Mainly because people that come up here these days, and people that are moving up here these days, the people that they're not antiques. So you need something for the modern times to take and get people interested in coming up here. And get your bass over here. Oh, that's a real winner.
I like where you're going, but do you have anything
else? You know what that's going to end up as? Get your ass over here.
Yes.
Well, no, that's, I think that's the correlation. But, do you have anything to offer? I mean, what as far as being modern, I'm curious what are you thinking?
Well, number one, I wasn't invited to be on this committee, so if you want to end up in the past, stay there.
You're invited now.
You do not take and move forward in the past unless you have some better ideas on that stuff.
Thank you for your comments. Hello.
Cheryl Wallman, 649 West 40th Street. It looks like you guys had a lot of fun doing this, I can tell. So I don't know if we're going to vote or not, but I want to vote. And they all, several of them look good, but I have to say my favorite is Clearlake Living the Lake Life. So.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Anyone else?
If you want to modernize it, we could put an apostrophe after the N.
Oh, there you go. There you go. We made it modern right there.
I was trying to think what we tried to get started as a motto quite some time ago. Rush, you should remember it.
He can't remember, so he's trying to get you to.
The cleanest, friendliest, what was it? It's a vision, is what it is. A vision.
Right. People need to
realize that. I think it was cleanest, friendliest, and safest.
That's what it was. Clearlake, cleanest, friendliest, safest city. I really like Clearlake where community comes first, because that really shows. And that's something we can stick by and live by and everything else, because that's what it's shown over all the disasters.
I was going to say, the Valley Fire and Rocky Fire were huge examples of just that.
Yep.
When we have flooding, huge examples of that, I agree.
Or when the tough gets going gets tough, or Clearlake gets tough or something. So, I mean, it's great to look at things like that and have fun with them and stuff. And
what is?
I like
to play on words.
Where community comes first, and get your bats over here. So.
Thank you. Anyone else? All right. I see no one else coming up, so I will close public comment and bring it back to council.
I'm gonna set it over here so you see.
Yes, Councilor Broberton.
Okay, we did have a lot of fun with this. And one of the things is we could use, like, you know, when you're going into cities, sometimes there's different signs that say different things. So we can use some of these things and other things that people give us and have, you know, if Caltrans will allow us to do that, put some signs as they come through town, like, get your pass back here, you know. Those are little things that we can put on other signs. It doesn't have to necessarily be our motto. So we were kind
of thinking in town, you know, just
right there. But you know, there's some play on some of those too, where we can use some of these, even though they may not be our motto, we can use them to put on other signs. I like both Clearlake Living the Lake Life. I really like that one because it kind of tells people we're kind of relaxed here. We're just kind of kicked back and enjoying life. And I also like the one where, you know, Clearlake Community comes first, because we're telling people we care about our city. So those are my two, as far as if I was going to take out of the Spanish, those were the two that come to my top of my list. You know, I like them both. They both have really good meaning. I think where community comes first really focuses more for our community to see on the sign. I think the lake life, for people who are coming in, is more saying, hey, we're a really kicked back community, and we're just relaxing and enjoying life. So to me, for tourism, that's kind of what they're looking for, something more to come in and say, and hey, relax here and have a good time. So those are my two favorite out of all. I like them all, but those are my favorite.
Okay, and thank you for your participation.
We laughed a lot.
Councilmember Sabatier?
I was going to say something similar in the sense that we don't have to choose one. I think, especially if we're going to be marketing, depending on where it is that we are marketing it, the different things.
Well, I guess you're correct, but a motto, typically you have one motto. We can use some of these for different types of advertising. Like, you know, I'm not really serious about making our motto "Get Your Bass Over Here," but it is something
you
that
did like it.
I did like it. But if we're doing, at some point in the future, we might get where we have a marketing budget and we can start doing some marketing, and maybe we market in some sportsman type magazines or something like that. Then "Get Your Bass Over Here," maybe that's an appropriate advertising kind of thing, but not necessarily potentially, you know, the motto of the city.
No. We don't want to see it on our letterhead.
Right, exactly.
I wonder, would be another way to combine the two, the Clearlake Living the Lake Life and where community comes first? Is there a way that, hey, Cheryl, you're good at this stuff. Is there a way to maybe combine those two in some way? Because I like them both. You know, it kind of is
where
what we do. We want to have people know that we're relaxing and everything, but that we really care about our community. So how can we combine those two? Or that's my opinion.
Unfortunately, I think we need to, as a motto,
it needs to stay short.
And it
I
needs
think.
To be succinct.
And I like
we
this
live
point,
where you vacation. Or like, you know, community.
Well, that's, I think,
where
the
community
where
meets
the lake life
vacationing,
yeah.
Or where.
Well, I think that's where the living the lake life is kind of what we were saying on that is, yeah. We live here, you're vacationing here, but we're living here, and this is the life.
They sort of serve two purposes, like you said. Where community comes first really speaks to people looking to move here, mm-hmm. to live here, find somewhere, you know, homey to.
Do you have something to add, Mr. Wilson?
Oh, I was just going to potentially go back to the previous slide, but then I got to go back through every one of those. Where, you know, just again, what a good motto is, it expresses a city's character, affinity, style, or personality. It tells a story in a clever, fun, or memorable way. It's unique and original. It inspires you to visit there, live there, or learn more about it. You know, and maybe that might even be the most important one to me, is it inspires you to visit there, live there, or learn more about it. So,
living the lake life,
man. That's the one that I'm leaning towards.
I like it.
And I like the alliteration of the L's. It makes it for a good motto as well.
And like I said, and then we can use the other ones still for different little signs, and as people come up with things,
sure.
little things we can, make these signs and still put out on the road where we're kind of just being funny or, you know, doing something, you know, fun where people can say, oh, they're living the lake life and they're having a good time doing it by putting these signs out on the road.
There you go. Vice Mayor?
No.
reference?
Well, I'm sort of going back and forth between the one that's really explicit is sun, fun, and fishing, like, we're being really literal about it, but it's not as much fun as some of the other ones. but it certainly does tell the story. I guess since what happens here stays here is already taken.
Yeah, I've heard that somewhere.
This is not Las Vegas, Gina.
Thank goodness.
All right. Well, I agree. I like the Clearlake living the lake life. I like that.
My very, very favorite one is one I knew we would probably pick. That's the one that's old. I just love that one.
I'm not trying to skew her.
Jeff wants to raise his hand. I can see it. I think it's
public comment still open.
I closed it, but we're way ahead of schedule, so I'll reopen public comment if anyone would like to get in on this discussion before we make a final decision.
It takes a long time for things to soak in with me. And that's a good thing sometimes. Clearlake, living the lake life. Where community comes first.
Well, that's what I was saying. That's what I was saying, is combining them.
But don't you agree that that's a very, it's very long for a motto?
Yeah, but what's our vision statement?
We're working on that today.
We're working on that, yeah.
Come to the goals and objectives meeting on the 19th.
Yeah,
that'll be a surprise.
Yes, the marketing committee's been working on that as well.
Because I thought even more and more, but I think it's more of a vision statement.
This
right.
is just a little
blurb
that we put out, and then
yeah. So I think, like, be prepared.
If you look at the ones that I gave all of you, you know, like, they're 5-6 words typically. Mm-hmm.
Well, here's one that says, "It's not the end of the earth, but you can see it from here."
Yeah.
So that's a little. That's kind of what make that same. I'm not sure about that one.
Yeah, I don't want to use that one.
I was just reading how long it was, because I think it's still short of that.
Still.
What I would suggest is that last one. If you put out a road sign or something of that nature, we'll leave that one off, because the first thing that will happen is somebody will come along and mark out your little bee. And what is your road sign going to say then, folks?
Well, we were right there with you when you said it.
Huh?
We were right to speed when you said it.
Yeah, we were kind of with the remarkable speed.
Because I don't know who came up with that one, but
it was for fun. It was good.
Good for what, Joyce?
It's good to laugh about, Derek. Sometimes you just gotta laugh. You know.
Yeah, but you don't advertise that to the whole county.
Sure.
Obviously, you folks do. I wouldn't.
I'm going to use that. I don't care if we use it or not. I'm going to use that.
Fine, use it.
Thank you. Anyone else? Final comments? Why, yes, sir.
You don't have comments.
Yes, I do.
Nick Bennett, Clearlake residents. I like the Clearlake where the community comes first. This is our community. I don't refer to it as our city. It's our community. We're trying to attract businesses into our community. We're trying to build up our community and attract residences into our community. And that's what we're trying to build here, a community. Even new industries, we're trying to make it part of our community. So. That's what we're building. So that's what we want to be first. The lady sitting next to me reminded me of the old Burmese signs. That would be a great thing to have, maybe a couple of places coming into the city. Forget the last one. I'm not with a lot of that.
Bumper stickers, guys.
Go fishing is something along those lines. But something along those lines for a summer to see a permanent shade type advertising.
And for those younger than us, Nick, a succession of signs is a dream yes, city
yes,
limits.
Just about
each of those things, and you get to read them as you go along.
If you go back,
Gina didn't know what we were talking about.
If you go out of state, if you go out of state on Highway 10, going back east, you still see them from the signs. So that's my vote, where community comes first, because it is our community.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
I didn't mean to steal
the thunder. All right. Ruby Weathers, Clearlake. And I like Clearlake where the community comes first. But I do like the idea of having signs along the highway. And an example of a Burma shape set of signs was around the curve, Lickety Split, it's a beautiful car, wasn't it? And that's when the speed limit was 25 miles an hour on the highway.
Good evening, Akila Makowski. I was listening when you all talked about combining two signs. I just wrote down a combination of two signs. Some of them I like and some obviously I don't like. Anyway, this is what I've done. Clearlake, Community First, and Lake Living. I combined them together so you can keep both, but just shorten them because you talked about there not being more than 5 or 6 words. So, or you could do another combination of that to talk about the community, which is first. It's one of the things that kept me here, that has kept me here. And the lake living, I don't do anything on the lake, but some people enjoy the lake. I just like looking at it when it's clean. So you might want to consider that one too, and I can repeat it if you'd like.
Please.
Clear Lake, Community First, and Lake Living.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank
you. Thank you all. Anyone else? All right, folks, I'll bring it back. We got a heck of a task ahead of us. So in the vision, I have a question. In the vision of this, where would you see the motto displayed, Mr. Folsom? What in other cities that you've been involved with?
Well, many times if you have an entry feature, mm-hmm. you have the motto with the entry feature.
Not so much on business cards, letterhead. I've seen it on those.
You could. If it's one that you feel that, you know, really mm-hmm. displays the character, then you could.
And it would probably be added on to any time we go back in the San Francisco Chronicle. And we
right.
Thank you. Councilman Sabate.
So I'm listening and I'm hearing that people like the where community comes first. That's how we feel about our community, our city. I don't see the same attraction to outsiders compared to living the lake life. And I think living the lake life is more vague and open to what is your type of fun on lake life rather than community first is more of a less, yeah, it's about, it's us and not so much what you'll enjoy if you just come here for a day or two, in comparison to more attracting people to want to move here, compared to bringing in tourism. Living the lake life, I think, offers both. I'm partial to both, but in my mind, I'm more edging towards the living the lake life.
Councilmember Rota.
Ten words if we went with combining those, if we wanted to do that. There are some in here that I've looked at, I was in here counting up to see that view. So if you went with the Clearlake, living the lake life and where community comes first or something in that format, it would be about 10 words. So you could combine them if we're not putting them on business cards and stuff. It still would be able to go across the bottom of letterhead, you know, letters or anything we could put on the bottom of our of our stationery. It wouldn't be something that, you know, you could put it on the advertisements still. It wouldn't go on business cards, you know, and you could still put it on our sign. So, you know, you could still have a sign that you could put that on. So it would be combining them both. I mean, that would be the best of both worlds. But if we're only going to choose one of those with living the late life. But I think we could combine them both and still be okay.
Well, and I guess what is the vision we want to share? When I look at Clearlake Living the Lake Life, I kind of envision a sunset chair on the beach, you know, kind of in front of it. It's kind of a relaxing scene.
You've been enjoying life.
But there's so much other things to do here. There's, you know, the fishing, the golf, the touring. There's just a lot of things that we enjoy.
The lake.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we kind of said that Living the Lake Life, because it entails what we do, but also entails what people can do when they come.
Right.
Because
we live here, we know that we are a strong, unified community when tragedy hits. And I do like that. We know the community comes first.
That's all I like, the idea that they were saying to put them down on our roads. I think you go with Living the Lake Life and use some of these for the little signs down our main street.
Well, I like them all, and I even like a lot of the comments that came up during public comment, but for a motto, we need to select the motto. And that's.
I mean, like, we just want to go with one of those, that's fine.
Okay.
Joyce, turn your mic on.
I said Living the Lake Life. That's my choice if we're going to choose from one.
Sorry to throw a wrench in there, but what if we tweaked it slightly and maybe offered Lake Life Living?
Yeah.
Just putting an option.
Yeah. And that's more of a sale, like you want to come buy property here. I mean, Living the Lake Life is more inviting to say, hey, come see what we're doing. We're living the lake life. You want to come join us? Type, let's have some, because we're trying to bring in tourism along with people in our community. So we're trying to combine one motto into two things. So I think Living the Lake Life is better to drop both of them in.
That's a good point. We have to look at what is our industry here. We have one. It's tourism, and it's getting people to come and want to fish and want to hike and see some of the beautiful things that we take for granted.
Life is better at the lake.
That's a sign on my wall.
Perfect.
So we know Councilmember Overton's. This is tough. Could stick for about 20 years.
To the next council.
6 months.
Consensus
is Living the Lake Life. We'll try that on for size.
Okay.
And in 7 months?
If we don't like it,
we'll see if it sticks. Thank you very much. And thanks to the folks at 7. Yeah.
I'm excited to match up this to the contest that we
have. Agreed.
Plus, we let people know that these are signs that we, as the ad hoc committee said, you definitely want to make and put out through the roadway so that we can attract. So I think these will all be used. I mean, we want people to know that we have the, you know, home of the international worm races. I mean, we think that's kind of funny, but you know, hey, that's what draws people in. Oh, hey, let's go check that out on the 4th of July.
If I'd have known that was a choice, I'd have been.
Yeah. So I just think we should use all of those on different signs around, or through our Clearlake here, whether it's on the highway or Democrats are green belt, you know, we need to, and I'm calling it the green belt because that's what I want it to be.
And I think on top of a picture that really showing what the lake like here, how it's unique to be living here this day. It's going to really have an impact. Like, we have mountains, we have the lake, we have.
And that's a very good point. That slogan, I think, captured on a mural or something similar to that, that would depict what we mean with the slogan or the motto. I think that would be pretty sharp. Something else just to throw it out there. Over the years, signs have popped up and through time and deterioration, have fallen down, been knocked down, that type of thing. I would be very interested if there were any artists out there or someone who might have an idea if they could approach on an office hour for some of those signs maybe to be replaced, or they'd like to offer some signage with
their talent.
Right, to show off their talent, but also to show off these pretty, you know, these catchy slogans and mottos. So I'd like to put that out there. I don't know if we could commission them for a price, but consensus, since we're kind of getting to that point in the meeting, to make this happen. I think it's part of our vision as far as cleaning the town up. I know in that intersection by Howard's Grotto, there was a nice sign that a community improvement group put up, and unfortunately a fellow that had a little bit too much while driving took it out. So, and it never got replaced. And some of the signage, that's what I'm referring to.
Okay. Are we still on the agenda?
I believe we are. I'm tying it into how can we make this a reality. It's nice to talk about it. It's nice to come up with a motto that will someday, but I'd like to see it happen yesterday. So what could we do to try to speed that process up?
I think we probably need to...
So I'm asking for consensus. Can we bring some of those ideas back, or just ask the public to come in and...
No, that's something we can discuss at the marketing ad hoc.
Okay, good. Please do.
And I'm hoping that as we get those contest entries, that we can attract those artists so we can get more and more.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Kind of like one behind you guys.
I mean, we want
to. He's trying to get move it. Move it to the community.
Please don't encourage the disruptions. All right. Mr. Folsom, do you have a report?
Just a couple of things, Mayor. Just want to report that we had a really good meeting with the county regarding the airport property. So we're continuing to move along with talking with the different taxing entities on that. Thank you for that. We have had, I'm going to steal the police department's thunder here since he's not on the agenda to make the announcement himself, but the police department has taken out approximately 15,000 illegal marijuana plants just in the last 2 weeks. They've arrested numerous people. They've taken a number of guns off the street. And I just want to reiterate, that's 15,000 illegal marijuana plants that have been taken out. And then just to remind you that you all did receive an invitation to the Health Leadership Network luncheon on Friday, May 6th. And that concludes my report.
Thank you, sir. Councilmember Overton.
I don't really have anything to report tonight, but I would ask one question. I don't know about you guys, but these tablet things are just really not working for me. The way the setup here is it's hard for us to fumble through and find things, and I think I've seen you guys do it a few times. We need to find a different setup on our agendas and how their things. I think we need to talk to the Lakeport and the county. Jeff was really easy, just point on it and it comes up, has all the information and the resolution and everything all with one, so the counties was simple. I know that the Lakeport, when I went to theirs, when they first got theirs, they had tabs that you just touched and basically kind of the same as the county. We need to figure out something on that. There's gotta be a system that works with this, because this is, for me, I'd rather just print it out. It's too hard. So I just wanna know if other councils would consensus to see if we can look into something better than what we're having.
Yes, and include training in that because
my mind is
sorry. Yeah. actually sat next to me at one of the ABC meetings.
Former Mayor Scheel.
Thank you. I did say that. Sat next to me, the former mayor of Lakeport sat next to me at ABC and had the same thing, and I couldn't do what he was doing on it. And he just reached over and pressed a few buttons, and then that whole thing that you're talking about with the tree and the ability to select a page came up. So some of it's just about
training,
our own training and upgrading of our personal skills and not necessarily getting something new or different.
Then we need training because I don't know.
I believe it was awkward.
We could probably get any teenager at Lower Lake High School to show us how to do it.
Well, or if they needed to hack into an iPhone for the FBI.
No. Okay, perfect.
Thank you. Anything else?
And there's also other ways to save documents that makes retrieval easier.
Okay.
So is there consensus on that?
Well, I think we would just need to approach the city clerk. She was offering training when we picked up the iPads. I didn't take advantage of it. So I'm guilty of that.
Would you be able to teach me how to put it all up where I could just touch it?
It was offered. I didn't take advantage of it. But
I would say between Melissa and Google, we could probably take care of our own rather than have staff look for other ways to do this.
Agreed. Anyway, thank you. Councilmember Sabatier.
I have no report other than I was part of the cleanup that we did last Saturday. It was beautiful to see so many people driving down the streets of Clearlake and watching so many different groups spread out all over the city in orange vests or yellow vests. There's something really thrilling about seeing the entire community moving together like that. So thank you to everybody that was part of it. And I just want to say thank you to one person or one group that we didn't say thank you to, and that was to Clearlake Waste Solutions. For their part in having all their people working there, all the dumpsters that they were going through. Again, I enjoyed it, so thank you to everybody that was a part of it. And also thank you to John Jensen, for putting that ad up for the Clear Lake contest for the logo. Appreciate that.
Vice Mayor?
Oh, I celebrated Earth Day with Ukiah High School students. It was really exciting. They did a thing where the students sort of took on an environmental issue and researched what they might do about it, how to address it, where it's coming from, that kind of thing, locally there in Mendocino. And they had some of their elected officials come in and listen to those presentations, among lots of other cool things that were going on that day. So that was a lot of fun. And I would love to have some students try to solve some problems for Clearlake and bring those forward to us. That would be fun. Also went to Legislative Action Day yesterday. I highly recommend it for all of us. I don't know if we can all go at once. We might have to split up into two and two, because we did definitely talk with our legislators about issues that we're having locally. And it was really powerful to be there with members of the entire Redwood Empire division and find out that we're having a lot of the same issues and that there's lots of different ways that they're manifesting and ways that people are addressing them around the state. So that was fun.
Thank you for going.
Yes, your turn next year.
Thank you. Concluded?
Yes.
Thank you. Also participated in the Cleanup Clearlake Day last Saturday. It is great to see people come out. I only, and I don't want to end this on a negative, but when we do this once a year, we have a lot of folks turn out, but we really need help in stopping those people who are creating those messes that we have to go out and clean up. The idea isn't for a group of people every year or twice a year to go out and clean up. It's to have a clean city year round. And I'm really hopeful that if anyone here in council chambers or out there watching through PEG sees people dumping illegally, if you could, we have the availability now of a camera in our pocket or hand at the ready, take a picture, help our police department, help code enforcement to keep our city clean all year round, not just on the days that a group of volunteers show up to go out and clean it up and to pick up several tons of trash. I've also heard when I'm out and about, kids, I watched a bunch of kids get off of the bus, I won't say where, and it was amazing to me the trash that came out of their hands and right on the ground as soon as they got off the bus. So clearly they don't have to throw it down on the bus, they get in trouble. but there wasn't any regard to throwing it down on the ground. So if we can help our young people understand that, you know, we live here, we'd want it thrown in your front yard, we don't want it thrown in ours. To do that, so much work got done that day, but again, we live in such a beautiful place, and it's going to take all of us working together to clean that up. And that's what I came away with from our Clearlake cleanup. Doug didn't say that we pulled a boat, abandoned boat out of the lake. I'm not sure if it was stolen or not, but it needs to be collected at the end of Dam Road at the gate, if it hasn't been already. Went to the legislative action. Things are very concerning at the state level. It doesn't appear as though action is going to be taken on state roads and infrastructure this year. They're trying to get it done before the end of the fiscal year, but comments made by both our senator and assembly member is it doesn't look good. It does not look promising. And everything that I heard while I was there yesterday with regard to roads and what we're trying to do here is it needs to be a local resolution. It needs to be locally resolved if you want to do anything, because we can't count on the state. We have to do it ourselves. We have to pull it up, bootstraps, and go to work. And I heard that time and time again. I'm very interested in what they might have to offer for homeless. I've had local folks here in the city wanting us to do something with our homeless problem, and we want to do something. We simply don't have the money that it requires. I applaud and commend Senator McGuire for trying to come up with a homeless bill. We talked about that at the legislative committee, and I appreciate the money that he's trying to come forward with, but it's nothing in what we would need. We have a lot of folks out there who have mental health issues, and there doesn't seem to be the funding there to address that. We're talking about looking at Prop 63 monies that may be used, but for Lake County, he felt maybe $250,000 might get started, and there might be grants available. My concern is that really would it help? You know, when we're talking about roads and what it would cost to fix roads, we're looking at millions of dollars just in the city of Clearlake, and that isn't coming from the state or the feds through gas tax. That well is dried up. So I throw that out there. I don't want to rain on the parade and close this meeting down on a bummer, but it's time to get busy, folks. It's time to clean up our town. We are the community, and we want to live in a better place. I know it. I see it. I see people excited with a little bit that we've done. We want to do a whole lot more, and I just want to thank each one of you for your leadership and helping us to move forward, because I think we're going in a good direction. And I want to thank those who have submitted applications for our vacancy. It closes May 3rd.
May 3rd.
So if you're interested in a position on council, submit those applications. All right. Anything else for good of the order before I close it down? Seeing nothing, we are adjourned.